because again, people think animation in Nigeria is for children. It's not for children. And if you want to really do, it's a global commodity. Exactly. Like in Africa, the highest grossing movie from Africa as we speak, it's Aside Ghost Must Be Crazy from South Africa. It's actually an animated film, Adventures of Kumba and Zambezi, by Triggerfish, an animation studio. Mm-hmm. The highest grossing film in Nigeria here came close to 500 million, right? And a lot of the distribution were done here locally. So you are telling me to create something for a market that is small, I don't understand it. Or are you telling me to look at the global picture and look for ways to distribute my film across? Mm-hmm. Because only in every year you might just find two or three animated films from Africa. They get a lot more traction when they are distributed than live action. Mm-hmm. So in telling our story here, one thing I think every studio and everyone who's interested needs to do is, first of all, put your research on ground. Mm-hmm. Our storytelling is so weak. It took us 10 months. We even went to Kano. We stayed in Kano for like a month. We went to visit the scenes, the Kano world, went to meet the Emir, we went to the libraries, because we didn't just want to take a book for it. In fact, we found some discrepancies between some of the accounts in the book and what was believed in Kano, so we had to bridge those gaps. Mm-hmm. In telling that, it took us 10 months. Then the second thing is your art, which for us, we're 2D studio, like we have a great capacity in doing that. So we're going 2D on this. And then the next thing is your sound, which is another area where we need to get right. If you can cover all three, you really go far, mm-hmm. right? And in telling that story, Nollywood is doing a great job, but I think Nollywood on the other level have not deepened our storytelling. Mm-hmm. And a lot of people, for you to travel globally as a product or a film, you need to carry a universal story that can cut across language barriers.
Yeah.
But in staying true to who we are, 20% of the content in our film is going to be Hausa language because it was set in Kano. So we are going to be hiring Kushi, Kashi, all those things. Mm-hmm. Right? Because we feel that we are proud of who we are and we are supporting who we are. So, and we want to drop our language, and even the soundtracks are going to be as Tuareg and as Hausa as they come. So develop that. Also,